Doctor Who. The planet Kemble. Its land masses covered in vast, inhospitable jungles, holding many dangers. In a forest clearing, Jeff Garvey is lying on the ground, barely conscious. Garvey wakes with a start, sitting up and peering about him in confusion. Quite suddenly, Garvey presses his hands to his temples, his face twisted in agony. At last, the pain passes. Garvey becomes calmer, dropping his hands as he begins to smile. Rising to his feet, Garvey pulls a gun from his belt.
I remember now. I must kill. Must kill.
Mission to the Unknown. Written by Terry Nation. A short distance away, Mark Corey and Gordon Lowry are attempting to repair their rocket ship. Grimly, Lowry peers out into the surrounding jungle.
Why you ever wanted to land on a planet like this in the first place, I'll never know. This is getting on my nerves.
I hate to think what kind of an animal makes a noise like that.
Yeah, we're getting closer.
Yes, all the more reason to stop talking and get on with the job.
Just you listen to me, Corey. I know my orders were to let you have full reign, and you've certainly taken advantage of that. But as captain of this expedition, my first responsibility is to get this ship off the ground. So just cut the chat. Some other time. Bring that ring.
How's it going?
Oh, it's slow. Flare back melted the retaining bolt. Just solid lumps of titanium. Some of it's free.
I want to have a look around.
Oh, listen. If we don't shoot off soon, we won't make the rendezvous with the freighter, you know? If we're not in the pickup orbit, they won't wait.
You make it, Larry. Here you are.
I'm doing the best I can. I didn't want to touch down this lousy plant in the first place, remember?
Let's not start that again. Just get on with the job, would you? What the devil's Garvey? You should be back by now.
I'll be here. A screwdriver, will you?
Corey hands Lowry the requested tool. Hidden in the dense foliage of the jungle, Garvey watches the two men continue working on the rocket's tail fin.
Kill.
He edges forward.
We should get some of it free. Look at it. Useless. Get me a spare, will you? Now in the ship.
As Corey heads back into the rocket, Lowry continues to work. Garvey edges closer, keeping the ship between him and the two other men, so that he cannot be seen.
Oh, it's no good, Corey. Needn't bother with a spare. Just not going to be able to fix it.
Bent over his work, Lowry is defenseless as Garvey raises his gun to fire. But it is Garvey who topples to the ground.
Jeff!
Caught in the blast of Mark Corey's ray gun. Lowry kneels beside Garvey, cradling his head. The fallen man writhes with pain and then lies still.
Kill him. You killed Jeff.
It was him or you.
You didn't give him a chance. You shut him down like an animal. You just shut him down!
Lowry launches himself at Corey, trying to strangle him. Corey punches him in the stomach. Lowry reels back, shocked and gasping, as Corey kneels down beside Garvey's body. He makes a cursory examination of the head and neck. and then with a grunt of recognition, removes a long thorn embedded in the flesh just below the ear.
A Varga thorn.
A Varga?
Careful, don't prick yourself with it. We'll end up the way Garvey is. I'll have to kill you.
What do you mean?
Let's get back into the ship.
What about his personal effects?
All right, but hurry up.
Lowry collects Garvey's belongings, then he and Corey disappear into the rocket ship, the door sliding shut behind them. Garvey lies on the ground where he fell, apparently dead. After a moment or two, however, the fingers of one hand begin to twitch and clench, the movement becoming more pronounced and violent. As the hand twists and turns, long white hair can be seen to be covering its back. And amongst the hair, a multitude of spiny Varga thorns are growing.
I didn't intend to tell you anything. But since we're stuck on this planet and Garvey's dead, there are some facts that you're entitled to know.
Yeah. Jeff Garvey's dead. And when we flew together for the last 10 years, and now he's dead, and you killed him. You better explain that fact and make it good.
Sit down and take a look at this.
Corey hands Lowry his ID.
I don't know. Space Security Service, license to kill.
That's right.
They'll count me out.
This other document gives me the authority to enlist the aid of any person, civil or military. You were just enlisted. From now on, Lowry, you can take your orders from me.
All right, all right. But I don't fully understand. Better fill in a few details.
All right. I suppose you've heard of the Daleks.
The Daleks invaded Earth 1,000 years ago.
That's right. Well, they haven't been active in our galaxy for some time now, but that doesn't mean they've exactly been sitting around. In the last 500 years, they've gained control of over 70 planets in the 9th galactic system, and of 40 more in the constellation of Miros.
Don't see why that should concern us. I mean, they're both millions of light years away from our galaxy.
That's what we all thought. But about a week ago, we had a report from the captain of a space freighter. His navigator spotted a spaceship of a type never before used in our system. He saw it only for a second, but he gave us a good description.
So?
What he described was a Dalek spaceship.
Outside the ship, Garvey's feet and legs are twitching with life, and from the waist up, his body is covered in long white spines. All resemblance to the human that was once Garvey is disappearing. He's becoming a Varga. Inside, Corey tries to make contact with the rendezvous ship.
Freighter XN2, Freighter XN2, come in, please. Come in, please.
Can you make it work?
It's got to work.
It may have been damaged in the crash.
We must keep on trying.
You tested the link pulses?
I know what I'm doing.
All right, so the link pulses work. There could be something else wrong with it. What about the vagometer? Have you tested that? Without that, you'd never break through the atmosphere.
How can I possibly test that? We've just got to take a chance that it hasn't been damaged. Freighter XM2, Freighter XM2, come in, please. Come in, please. It's useless. Are you sure we can't repair this ship?
Well, there's not a chance. It's hot. So you think that the Daleks have established some sort of base here, is that it?
It could be. This is the most hostile planet in the universe. People from other civilizations avoid it. I suddenly had a hunch that this might make an ideal place for any secret preparations that the Daleks wanted to make. That's why we brought this ship down here.
Did you tell anybody else about this hunch of yours?
No one. Not even your commander. I just asked for a couple of men and a small rocket. I didn't even tell him what for.
And why are you telling me?
Because of this. A thorn from a Varga plant. A thing part animal, part vegetable. Looks like a cactus. The poison attacks the brain. Rational thought is replaced by an overwhelming desire to kill. Eventually, the poison seeps through the system, and the victim is gradually transformed into a Varga.
And what's that got to do with the Daleks?
The only place in the universe where Vargas grow naturally is on the Daleks' own planet.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.